is risen. Alleluia! And he has overcome death. It's Easter Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Siame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Stay tuned.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Easter Monday of the 18th of April 2022 in the octave of Easter. And participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Mary Mutimbutsia from Lilongwe, Malawi, takes for us the first reading. Sister Marcelline Twinemugisha from Ave Maria Community in Fort Porto, Uganda, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming for us the gospel is Father Dennis Atanga, a Chameleon Father from Nairobi, Kenya. Let us pray. O God, who give constant increase to your church by new offspring, grant that your servants may hold fast in their lives to the sacrament they have received in faith. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. This Jesus God raised up, and of all that we all are witnesses. A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Acts chapter 2, verse 14, then 22 to 33. On the day of Pentecost, Peter, standing with the 11, lifted up his voice and addressed them. Men of Judah and all who dwell in Jerusalem, let this be known to you, and give ear to my words. Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God with mighty works and wonders, and signs which God did through him in your midst, as you yourselves know this Jesus, delivered up according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God, you crucified and killed by the hands of the lawless men. But God raised him up, having loosed the pangs of death, because it was not possible for him to be held by it. For David says concerning him, I saw the Lord always before me, for he is at my right hand that I might not be shaken. Therefore my heart was glad, and my tongue rejoiced. Moreover, my flesh will dwell in hope. For you will not abandon my soul to Hades, nor let your Holy One see corruption. You have made known to me the ways of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. Brethren, I may say to you confidently of the patriarch David that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. Being therefore a prophet, and knowing that God has sworn with an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants upon his throne, he foresaw and spoke of the resurrection of the Christ, that he was not abandoned to Hades, nor did his flesh see corruption. This Jesus God raised up, and of that we are all witnesses. Being therefore exalted at the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit, he has poured out this which you see and hear.
The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm, is taken from Psalm 16, verse 1 to 2a, and 5, 7 to 8, 9 to 10, then 11. The response is taken from verse 1. And the response is, "Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge."
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge. Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge.
Preserve me, O God, for in you I take refuge. I said to the Lord, you are my Lord. O Lord, it is you are my portion and cup. You yourself forsake, you are my Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew 28, verses 8 to 15. At that time, the women departed quickly from the tomb with fear and great joy, and ran to tell his disciples. And behold, Jesus met them and said, "Hail!" And they came up and took hold of his feet and worshipped him. Then Jesus said to them, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brethren to go to Galilee, and there they will see me." While they were going, behold, some of the guard went into the city and told the chief priests all that had taken place.
And when they had assembled with the elders and taken counsel, they gave a sum of money to the soldiers and said, "Tell people, his disciples came by night and stole him away while we were asleep. And if this comes to the governor's ears, we will satisfy him and keep you out of trouble." So they took money and did as they were directed. And this story has been spread among the Jews to this day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Yesterday on Easter Sunday, we took the first reading from Acts of the Apostles, chapter 10, where Peter addressed the pagans. Today, it is chapter 2, Peter addressing the believers, the Jews, who needed to consolidate their faith by understanding that God had done something more. And that something more is the raising of Jesus from the dead. He was raised from the dead. And that was meant to consolidate the faith of the Jews and all those who were to believe in Christ later. That was going to be the mystery of our own faith. That we proclaim every day in our Mass. When we celebrate Mass after the consecration, we say the mystery of our faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will come again. And that we proclaim with all confidence. Peter stands up to talk. A rare event. A man who was timid. A man who was able to say, "I do not know Jesus." A man who never spoke much in the Bible. Yes, he would say something to try to affirm his faith. A man who even at one point was called Satan. "Get behind me, Satan." Because he had misunderstandings of Christ. Now can stand up confidently to speak about Jesus. This is the proof of his resurrection. He stood up in front of all those people who had come for the feast of the Passover after the coming of the Holy Spirit to speak with boldness, with confidence about Christ, the risen one. And he was able to say, "Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God with mighty works and wonders and signs which God did through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. And he was put to death, as you yourselves know." And he continued to say, "This Jesus delivered up according to the definite plan and foreknowledge of God, you crucified and killed by the hands of lawless men." You crucified and killed. He wants those who are listening to be part of that killing. He wants them to understand that they crucified him by their sinfulness. He wants them to understand that they put him to death by their own wretchedness. And what he preached is what I'm preaching today, because the word of God is alive and active. You have to play a role in this. You crucified Jesus by your own sinfulness. You crucified Jesus by your own wretchedness. You crucified Jesus by your own negligence of other people's needs. You crucified Jesus by your own negligence. You crucified Jesus by your own thoughts that are more destructive than constructive. You crucified Jesus by the way you treat your own brother, your own sister. You crucified him. It is only when you accept that you will understand the message of conversion contained in the resurrection of our Lord Jesus Christ. That you will understand why you have to think of a new life. A new life that demands from you a certain amount of witness to this risen Lord. And he said, "This Jesus God raised up, and of that we are witnesses." Being a witness means being able to show with the confidence you have in your own faith that you are serving a God that is alive. the confidence that Peter showed. A mere fisherman, a man who had no much of theology, but he was able to quote left and right the scriptures that we see him quoting from the Old Testament and applying to the situation of Jesus Christ, because he understood the word of God is alive and active, and he was able to tell them this is exactly what God has done. Our God works according to plan, and this plan he has fulfilled in raising Jesus from the dead. For you will not abandon my soul to Hades, nor will you let your Holy One know decay. He quotes this from Psalm 16 verse 10. He's quoting scripture and he's seeing in that the fulfillment of God's plan. Oh, wonderful. Peter shows us how we are going to be witnesses of the resurrection. We are going to be witnesses of the resurrection by the confidence we display in the faith we have in God. And as witnesses, we are letting the world know that our faith is not in vain. Our God is alive. Our God keeps working in our own lives. That confidence is shown in the way we live our own lives, like the women in the gospel passage of today. The women who, with fear and great joy, upon hearing the message of an angel that Jesus is alive, ran to tell the disciples. They went to tell the disciples not because they were very convinced of what they had experienced. No, they had their own doubts. That fear in them was a mixture of the vision they had of an angel who appeared to them and told them that Jesus is not here, he is risen. And the fear that this might not be the case, maybe they are just having hallucinations. They went with their own doubts, but great joy accompanied their doubts. Great joy removes all doubts and fears. Great joy in our lives as believers indeed indicates that we are witnesses. When people see us in the midst of confusion, with all that we are concerned about, the doubts we have in our lives, but we go through life with joy, people are going to see that we are men and women of the resurrection. We have confusion in our marriages. We have confusion in our workplaces. We have confusion with our own children. There are issues that we don't know when they are going to be solved in our children, in our own spouses, in our own workplaces, the financial problems we have. Yet, with this fear, we go around to tell others about Christ with joy. Great joy. And when we do that, Christ meets us on the way. When we display that joy in our lives, even when we carry so much to doubt about, doubting about our own health, not knowing how long we are going to live in this world, we still go on with a smile in our faces. And as we do that, Christ meets us on the way, as he did to the women, hell. And they came up and took hold of his feet and worshipped him. Jesus said, "Do not be afraid. Go and tell my brethren to go to Galilee, the place where he met them first, the place where it all began." He wants to remind them that if they want to renew their faith, they have to go back from where it began. They have to go back to those moments they felt enthusiastic about their own life. They have to go back to those moments they felt life had just begun. If you want to renew your faith, even in that marriage that seems to be breaking, go back to the first moments of your being together. Go back to those moments. Remember how you felt when you met each other. Something will be renewed. He wants them to go back to Galilee, and there he will meet them. And so Jesus makes this message known to them, and they carry this message to the disciples. They become the first evangelizers of God's resurrection to the disciples, the apostles of the apostles. But then we see something else happening. While the world of faith was rejoicing, we see the world of social media trying to twist the news. We see the world of the pagans trying to twist something, accepting corruption when others are enjoying the new life. Corruption has been an old trade, and it is taken by those who don't want to understand the resurrection. If you are a child of the resurrection, you won't participate in any corrupt activities that prevent life. You are a child of the resurrection and you have to fight for life. They were preventing the life of the risen Lord. No, tell them he has just been stolen. No, Christ has not been stolen. The body of Christ has not been stolen. And you and I are a proof that indeed Christ has risen. His body was not just stolen from that tomb, which remained empty. The empty tomb tells me God is alive. And that God who is alive has made me to commit my life to him to the end of my own mortal life. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Easter Monday to you. Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah, hallelujah.